happened?
I don't know. That's why I'm trying to get Steve to tell me. He's saying someone injected Jocelyn with a chemical.
You're saying the mark on the arm was from the injection?
Yeah, Alexis, too. They were both given the same thing.
Well, how do you treat it?
At this point, we don't have a protocol.
You can't help my little girl?
We're doing everything we can for Jocelyn and Alexis, but right now, all we know is that it appears to have been intentional.
You're saying somebody did this on purpose?
Who would want to make Jocelyn and my mom sick? What kind of lunatic injects a little girl?
I wish I had the answers.
What was in the injection? How are you going to treat it?
We're counting on the medications to do their job and keep the fevers down. I'll be back with an update.
How did this happen? When did this happen?
My mom had to go to Windermere last night. Some security issues, but she doesn't remember anything after she got there.
But that's where she fainted?
And possibly where she received the injection.
Are you going to tell me that Jocelyn was at Windermere?
We're going to figure it out. Okay, you just need to focus on Jocelyn. That's it.
Alexis and Jocelyn's marks are both on their forearm, as if somebody chose that site for the injection.
I still don't understand who would do this. Why?
Maybe Dr. Keenan can answer that.
It's understandable you're upset, Jason. It's possible you're just projecting.
No, I'm not.
Why would you even have any answers about Jocelyn and Alexis?
McBain and I saw him at Windermere today.
Wait, you and John went to Windermere together?
We were checking on any evidence of what happened to Alexis. And all we found was Dr. Keenan.
If you knew something about your mom, he would have told you.
What were you doing out of Windermere?
He used to live there.
Used to.
Yes, as I explained to Jason and Lieutenant McBain, I left a number of my belongings at the house.
And so you went back today to get them, or?
No, actually, I got a call from the security company. Apparently, there was a break-in, and they just wanted to let me know in case any of my things had been disturbed.
Why didn't you go out last night?
Well, I only checked the message this morning, and I don't keep anything of value there anyway.
It's kind of like the same call my mom got.
Yeah, that call was a fake.
What are you talking about?
Security company has no record of getting in touch with Alexis.
So there was no alarm?
It was a setup. Somebody wanted Alexis out of Windermere.
What are you saying, that somebody set my mother up? They got her to go out to Windermere just so they can inject her with something? What kind of a psycho would do that?
I'm trying to find out.
What if we don't have time, Jason?
Sam, what happened? What's wrong with Mom?
Come with me.
It's a good thing you didn't pick up that message till this morning. For all we know, you could have been injected, too.
I have a patient waiting, but please page me if their conditions get worse, okay?
He's really lucky you waited to go to Windermere.
You sure it's luck?
Aren't you?
Christina!
Oh, thank God, you got such a...
I'm sorry!
Stop. You're here now. That's all that matters.
She looks so weak. Oh. Did you hear? It's Molly.
I'd like to speak with you and your sisters alone, please. Christina, come find me when you're done, okay?
Molly, you know, like Sean said, we're not going anywhere until we know it's all good, okay?
You pretty much just accused Ewan of lying.
He is lying.
How do you know?
Why would Dr. Keenan get the same fake phone call that Alexis did?
And why would Alexis and Jocelyn, two basically unconnected people, be shot up with the same mystery toxin? And why is it strange for Ewan to be a target?
I don't know, but it doesn't add up.
Okay, so the alternative is what? That Ewan is somehow involved in all of this?
It's possible.
I wish I had better news to report, but your mother isn't responding to the medication.
Her fever's still going up?
And so is her heart rate. If we can get her temperature down, she risks damage to her major organs, especially the brain.
Oh, my God.
And if the brain shuts down, so does the body.
I can't believe we're even talking about this. Even as a doctor, he would never do anything to hurt anyone, especially a child.
Then why is he lying about what happened to Windermere?
So what if he got the same phone call as Alexis and he went to Windermere this morning and not last night? That doesn't make him a liar. It doesn't prove that he's done something
wrong.
There's
too many inconsistencies, starting with the night that you met him.
He saved my life.
No, he walked away and left you after you almost drowned. He was covering then, and he's covering right now.
Are you sure this is all about you, Ewan?
What does that mean?
Well, maybe you're trying to be Sam's hero by figuring out what's going on with her mom.
Hey, Alexis isn't the only one who's sick. We're talking about a little girl who's taken out of her bed in the middle of the night.
I'm sorry. I know you're scared for Jocelyn. So am I. But I think you may be right. I think you might be projecting because you feel helpless. And for whatever reason, you don't like
him. No, I don't trust him. And I don't think you trust him either.
Don't tell me how I feel.
Elizabeth.
I finally decided to date him. And you know what? I like him.
And then be careful.
Don't try to protect me. I can take care of myself. Wait. There must be something you can do.
Please, you can't just let her die.
I'm sorry.
Goodbye, Doctor. And don't hang up.
Thought you had a patient.
He wasn't able to come in. It's just frustrating. I had to do the session by phone. Excuse me. Dr. Weber, any progress?
Not yet. The time is running out.
Anything I can do?
The only thing I have to do is wait.
You can't just give up on my mother. There has to be another way, another medicine to bring down the fever, please.
Let's take another look at her.
For her daughter's sake, and for all the people who love her. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
I'm so sorry.
No.
Dr. Rashi was right. There's nothing else we can do.
How much time?
Not long.
Alexis, hear our voices, and may they give our strength to survive. Let Jocelyn feel the love in this chapel today. Let her hear our voices, and let them heal her. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Jocelyn? Jocelyn?
They say that the tragedy is to die young, but I don't agree. To die when you know what death means. When all the illusions are stripped away and you realize that you're really quite frightened after all. That's the tragedy.
So Alexis's death counts for more than your niece?
Oh.
Is that what you're saying?
It should be ending just about now.
Hey, Johnny, what's going on? I don't know. It doesn't sound good, though.
Jocelyn, you gotta hang on. Jocelyn, we need a doctor in here!
Help!
Jocelyn, baby, wake up! Wake up, baby, hey, come on!
Carly, come on.
You gotta save her! You have to save her!
Move.
What is that? Why is it making that noise? Mom's not dead! She can't be dead!
What's happening to our mother?
If your niece and Alexis Davis are dead, just say it.
Oh, quite the contrary. I'd never do anything to harm my niece. I love that child.
Jocelyn?
body.
Yeah, baby.
I'm thirsty.
You're thirsty? Thirsty.
By now, a fever must have broken. Jocelyn must be out of the woods. As it turns out, I'm also quite fond of Alexis as well.
Mom! Can you hear us? We're all here. Sam, Molly, and Christina.
Is there a reason that you think I wouldn't know your names?
Alexis and Jocelyn's fever broke. They're stabilizing. They're gonna be okay.
Oh my God.
Imagine their loved ones are currently celebrating. Hugs and kisses all around. I do feel badly that Alexis and Jocelyn endured a day of suffering. But it was necessary to keep them safe.
Don't you ever scare us like that again.
And now they will be. What I gave them last night was an inoculation. A vaccination of sorts. Or as I prefer to call it, protection.
Protection from what?
What I'm about to unleash on everyone else in Port Charles.